evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. I'd like to welcome you to the Methodist Centre tonight. Thank you all for coming along. The programme will go through unannounced. There won't be an interval. The refreshments will be served at the end of the final hour. And there's been one omission to the programme. There'll be no one fired in the soul tonight. Reading from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 11, verses 1 to 9. The royal line of David is like a tree that has been cut down, but just as new branches spread from a stump, so a new king will arise from among David's descendants. The Spirit of the Lord will give him wisdom, and the knowledge and skill to rule his people. He will know the Lord's will and have reverence for him, and find pleasure in David. He will not judge by appearance or hearsay. He will judge the poor fairly and defend the rights of the helpless. At his command, the people will be punished, and evil persons will die. He will rule his people with justice and integrity. Wolves and sheep will live together in peace, and leopards will lie down with young goats. Calves and lion cubs will feed together, and little children will take care of them. Cows and bears will feed together, and their calves and cubs will lie down in peace. Lions will eat straw, as cattle do. Even a baby will not be harmed that plays near a poisonous snake. On Zion, God's sacred hill, there will be nothing harmful or evil. The land will be as full of knowledge of the Lord as the seas are full of water. Here endeth the reading.
Thank you. announced. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to a town in Galilee named Nazareth. He had a message for a girl promised in marriage to a man named Joseph, who was a descendant of King David. The girl's name was Mary. The angel came to her and said, "Peace be with you. The Lord is with you and has greatly blessed you." Mary was deeply troubled by the angel's message, and she wondered what his words meant. The angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary. God has been gracious to you. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High God. The Lord God will make him a king, as his ancestor David was, and he will be the king of the descendants of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end. I am the Lord's servant.
Thank you.
was born in the town of Bethlehem in Judea during the time when Herod was king. Soon afterwards, some men studying the stars came from the east to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the baby born to be the king of the Jews? We saw his star and came up in the east, and we have come to worship him." When Herod heard about this, he was very upset, and so was everyone else in Jerusalem. He called together all the chief priests and the teachers of the law and asked them, "Where will the Messiah be born?" "In the town of Bethlehem in Judea," they answered, "for this is what the prophet wrote: Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, you are by no means the least of the leading cities of Judah, for from you will come a leader who will guide my people Israel." So Herod called the visitors from the east to a secret meeting and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem with these instructions: "Go and make a careful search for the child, and when you find him, let me know, so that I too may go and worship him." And so they left. And on their way, they saw the same star they had seen in the east. When they saw it, how happy they were. What joy was theirs. It went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. They went into the house, and when they saw the child with his mother Mary, they knelt down and worshipped him. They brought out their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, and presented them to him.
Being born as the children of the human father. God himself was their father. The word became Thank you.
we sing the final call, and before we break from this pies and coffee and tea, I'd just like to say a few words of thanks. First of all, I'd like to thank the Bishop and Minister for allowing us to use the church facilities in good time today. And I'd like to thank to the Parents and Teachers Association and the One Economics Department for doing the fresh Christmas lunch. The Economics Department have done the mince pies, vegetarian ones I might add. And the Teachers and Parents Association has been making the coffee. I'd like to thank John for playing the organ tonight, accompanying the Christmas carols, and also for accompanying the senior choir. And I'd like to thank Sandra Woods too, because she's given up nearly every Wednesday evening after school to accompany the orchestra. Thank you very much. I'd like to thank the teachers this evening who have done the readings, and also to Mr. Shaw, Mr. Crowder, who collected the money on the go as we came in. And more importantly, the people who are sitting here and there, behind them. They're wonderful, aren't they? Yeah? They've worked really hard since September. Yes, you have. And I'd just like to round off with this crowd anyway, a nice round of applause.
Merry and peaceful Christmas and New Year. Merry Christmas and New Year.